Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. I'm here. I'm just setting up. I still have to set up. Let me know if the music is too loud. I can always turn it down a bit. And I think I've turned up my gain for my mic, so that should be okay. Don't read it. It was me testing stuff. And thanks for the workout recommendation. Hi, Barry. Will you start the workout now or later? Don't thank me yet. You'll start later? Okay. I mean, it's kind of like the thing I needed, because I was getting sad that I've been trying to find my ring fit, but I haven't been able to find it. It's been a couple weeks now, and I'm getting a little sad that I can't find it. So it was nice that I could, you know, that we could start like a workout challenge and I don't need a ring fit for it. And hi, Shafani. Adamak. Am I saying that right? Hoi hoi. My clip studio is still loading. Oh, it finished loading. Cool. Nia. Oh, hello, Nia. How are you? I saw this other artist on my welcome page for Twitch, and their art looks so cool. It looks super cool. I just followed them now just to lurk at least and check them out later. Do you know of them? Apparently they have a partner who also streams and wears a nun outfit. Oh, she's popular? Okay. Is she nice? Excuse me. Okay. She's nice and very fun. All right. I'll keep a lurk. I just saw their line art and thought, wow, that's really, really good. Well, I do have a question to ask. So I'm trying out this thing. Could you let me know if it looks better with it or without it? It's a little slideshow of, I think, good art pieces I've done. I put it also in my art scene for when drawing. Or like any artsy stuff. I don't have it in the web browser one, and I have another scene for games. I don't have it there either, just in the art one. But do you think it looks good in this like welcome scene or without it. With 100%? Okay. Okay. I'll leave it then. Whoa!
J's time for what is time? Time for coffee, time for tea, time for friends, time for the sea. This stream is a place I like to be. Dot with my hot cocoa, looking for free tea.
That's a nice message. And thanks for the sub. 32 month streak. I think you're my longest subscriber and probably the one that unlocks my badges. But thanks for hanging out for so long. I'm surprised you're not bored yet. Okay, let me lower this a little bit. Hopefully that sounds okay. I completely changed my art thing. I made it much more simple. Oh wait, hold on. Ah, there we go. Need to add that here. Here. Hey, now it works. Still pumped? Sweet! Keep that good energy. It's good to have. Are you going to... Do you still have to wait for it to dry? Or are you going to... do a giveaway for your onion? I like the way it feels when you leave me in rust. Said you wanna see my best side. Oh, what time is it for you? And then repost it. Okay. 13-13. Wait. It's 13-13 for you? For Barry, yes. And for me too. Oh, so we're in the same time zone then. Okay. Now I understand. It's still morning. Sounds like a very relaxing morning. I got a little cold this morning. So I woke up a little bit earlier at around 8-ish and then went back to sleep enjoy the lyric and good luck at work. It wasn't that bad. Tame the chaos. How's your morning so far? True, I only have like the water stuff and the fish left, and then finally coloring. The fastest part. I tried to do some not on stream, so I can kind of feel like it goes faster on stream. Then I also... Okay, so some of the changes I did for this is completely get rid of the borders that I had. Because I thought, like, what is their purpose? Why are they there? And their purpose was so that the animation that I was supposed to make that I never made would look like it's in the background. And then, like, have some sort of text saying something, but you don't really need text all the time. So I thought, like, okay, their purpose they have outlived their purpose, so don't need them. Changed my SNS thing, so instead of, like, for example, on the home screen I used to have, like, on the yellow part, my username pop up for the different SNS like Twitter, Twitch, Instagram. And then I just changed it into a little QR code. So if ever you're interested, it like takes you to my landing page where all this stuff is there. So I added it to the art part also. And then like over here, I added the artwork and like a line saying commissions open. Hold on. Filters. Oh, I see. I did a boo-boo. Give me a second. I added the same thing to the home chat, but paste reference. I took some inspiration ideas from the artist we were talking about last time. The one that you were like, didn't really vibe with her. And then I was like, yeah, I get what you mean. No. Oh, transform, flip horizontal. Okay, let's see if works. Yeah, that one. I liked how clean her her overlay looks like. And I've just been getting really bored of all the boxes that we make. You know, like a box for your screen, a box for a follower, a box for someone who donates, and a box for like a subscriber, and then a box for chat, and yeah. let me see. Okay, no, it became the same. All right. I'll figure that out later. It's okay. Okay, everything's set. But yeah, so at least this way, at least this way, I hope that the main thing, which is the art, is like on the biggest part of the screen. And there aren't many distractions. And then I figured chat doesn't always need to be on screen. Maybe like for when we're just talking. Because I don't put it on the game screen. And if someone's like really curious as to what chat is saying, like when you're watching it on YouTube or something, then, you know, maybe they just come to Twitch. I don't know. Your resolution is good so far. But I get what you mean. Well, if ever I can help with something, I'll help. $480? I thought it wasn't it at like 720 or something? It looked really crispy on my end when you were playing Hugh and the apartment full of cats, what's it called? Like, that looked really clear. I don't remember what pixel size it was, so. Whenever you get big, don't forget us little people. And if someone interviews you and asks you about your humble beginnings and what it's like to stream as a female, you know, don't forget your friends. You never know. I really actually thought that, like compared to my friend EB. But then I had to move countries, and like all my stuff was in boxes in a crate on a ship somewhere in the Pacific Ocean. So I didn't stream for like 3-4 months. And people tend to forget you very quickly. So my friend Evie ended up getting surpassing me in the meantime. I'm proud of her though. Now she has like, I think like the double digits for viewership. So she's like 20, 23, something like that. And I think she has like 1.2 thousand followers now on Twitch. Don't forget the tiny people. Yeah, it kind of sucked a bit. And I was a bit sad because it was kind of like, you know, it's like part of your income. Or at least when you have income from different things, from different areas in your life. But hey, we just, I think it's just like because we do different things. We have different like life paths. She didn't necessarily need to do such a big move. Aww. Oh man. You could do so many things with channel points. Would you like to be a VIP in this channel? Barry does workout on stream! I would do that. We work out with you?
I'm out of control. You don't know how much it hurts to break the night. You need to know who you're sleeping next to. Tell me what you're up to. Thanks, I'm you.
Sorry, I like this song. You're already a VIP. I'm gonna make you a true VIP. Give me a sec. How do I do this? Oh. Community roles. Add. Excuse me. Man, there are so many toxic people. Toxic Girlo, Toxic TX, Toxic X Eternity, Toxic Copy, Toxic Boss, Toxic Gaming Weed, Toxic Bunny. And now you can do a special command, I believe. It's like exclamation point VIP. You're a VIP! Woohoo! dance. Oh, it's not here. Trying to look for sounds. No worries. None at all. Ah, here we go. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more. This one is like better. Hold on, hold on. Hey, party time! It's in the about page if you wanted to play sounds for free. Can't touch this. But no. Can't touch this.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
There you go. Now you're a VIP. And you can do the VIP command. Oh, and also congratulations on meeting your goal on coffee. I hope the videos, the lessons are useful. The art ones. And it was really smart of you to have your coffee open from the start. You got this! You can do it. I believe in you. You have the motivation. You have the goals. You have the will to breathe art. True. True. Then my dreams of being a housewife could finally come true. I'll stay pretty rich for the meantime. And then I'll thank all the friends along the way. I remember when I lost my mind. But there is something so pleasant about that place. I'm guessing you're not an Elon a fan. I miss her. She loved cuddling. Really? I don't think he's doing a bad job. But then again, I just don't really read many tweets. Where did I post it? Tell me, how is he ruining Twitter? I should have bought this also when I saw it. This was at Action. I haven't seen it since, and I regret it. Because it was like a simple bamboo tumbler. It was perfect. Anywho, side note. There we go. This is the first one I did. I didn't want to spend a lot of money on embroidery thread because I already had some from when I was like a preteen teenager, because I was really into those friendship bracelets and I got like really good that I wanted like the rainbow in threads, so I didn't want to buy them again, so I just bought like random yarn. So that's why it looks like popping out. Oh, thanks. It's my business card. This thread, I think, is from one of the art stores by the city I live in. I think it's this one that shows up on the right side. I'll let you know the details if you want to know later. But yeah, that's what I did first time. I did a second one, but I didn't finish it because I think I need to do better designs. I'm not good at designing this stuff. I'm just good at doing it, I think. Verification's not so bad. Let me see. Get verified. Twitter blue. Businesses govern nonprofits. Oh, so in order to be, you need to pay in order to be verified. Oof. Let's see, longer tweets, edit, NFT. Yeah, they could come up with VIP. Or just a different way to verify an account so that you're not a bot. Like this part, I remember a couple of artists talking about it, the prioritizing rankings and conversations and search. And the Western artists I follow say, oh no, this is gonna screw us. And now they're killing the artists. Nobody cares about artists. Blah, blah, blah. And then I responded to, like, I think two people saying, well, if nobody gets it, then nothing changes. And we're all still the same. Like, in that sense, you're... It's like creating a need for customers, like, you know, customer marketing of creating something that they think they need but they don't really need. Because I remember somebody saying how, like, I think they were apologizing on a tweet saying, like, you know, I'm sorry that it got Twitter blue, but I'm a business and an artist, and Twitter is partially how I make my income. And I thought, like, okay, cool, that's fine. But if we just don't get it at all, like, if none of us get it, then still there's no change. You're, you know, it's the concept of working with each other rather than trying to be better than the other person. Leave the verification to real people, artists, etc. True. I think that's what they were doing. Like, I think you had to provide ID or something. There we go. Switch it to this. Like, to verify that you are actually Will Smith. I can exit this window. All right. I'm sure they can do other types of verification that doesn't need to be monetized. Like, for example, your email or your phone number or something else, like a, like that verification code app thingy. Probably the Twitter blue check mark, I think, is mostly his way of creating revenue for Twitter, though, because Twitter was, like, basically bankrupt and not a good economic business decision on his part. So I think it's more of, like, you know, creating money for the app rather than, and then, like, hiding that behind the reasoning of verification and getting rid of bots. But I get what you mean. Verification in this way is not so smart. Okay, counterpoint, if I may. Just a counterpoint. I'm not arguing, I'm just throwing out a counterpoint. Oh yeah, he was trying to fix something. I think now it's okay though. Like, he got it up to 10,000 and whatever. He was tweeting as they were fixing it. I don't know what that was fully about. Hey Doodle, what's up? I have a good counterpoint though for why Elon Musk isn't so evil. Bring it? Okay, so there was this dude, and I'll pull up the, I think I put it under my bookmarks, but I bookmark so many things. Let me see if I can search it. I see him as just like this South African guy who was not like cheap poor, but was not like super duper uber rich. So I think, like, growing up, he had the financial means to study a lot. Media. Let me go. Hold on a second. My counterpoint is coming. Give me a second. Just need to search. Oh, this song is so cool. Also DMCA free. Oh, this is funny. where did it go? You agree, Barry? A Bond villain? I'm Bond. Elon Bond. Did he? Oh, he's celebrating May the 4th. That's so cute. Doesn't he have like 7 kids or something now? I'm trying to find this thing, but maybe it's not on his feed. Let me search something else. Okay, so this is from the Daily Wire. So here's my counterpoint. The Daily Wire posted a video, a movie from Matt Walsh about like what it's called. The title is Why Is a Woman? And talks about like, I guess just like cultural phenomenon that has been happening recently, and Twitter blocked it, and then Elon basically, the official report was that they resigned, but I think Elon just fired them for trying to hide this video, this movie, from everybody, in the sense that like you can't comment, you can't like it, you can't retweet it, which now you can. It was solved like I think the day that it was posted. So counter argument, Elon Musk is not aligning himself with any particular person, but rather just truth and the freedom to have discussions. That's my counterpoint, which by the way has also kind of, I think, is kind of happening on YouTube. Well, yeah, he has to make money also. But I think it's also happening on YouTube if people are avoiding saying particular words like transphobic, gay, racist, whatever, so that way videos aren't demonetized, which like I think that would be a problem in itself if you can't like, yes, there are some words that are problematic, but the words I just said, I don't think are problematic. So, for accounts to be... What's the word? What's the proper word? Blocked, in a sense? Or demonetized for that? I don't think that's right. And hey, Block, how are you? We're talking about Elon Musk. I said my counterpoint. might not be he is aligning himself with anyone on purpose. Yeah, I think for him, like, as a fellow Aspie, I think he just cares about truth. Not a person, per se. Well, I don't know his personal finances, but I think it would be a bad business model to not continue to make money. Especially since he, like, is popping up with new research stuff. Alt-right? What's the alt-right? Go woke, go broke crowd. I have never heard about that. Remember, I've been living somewhere else. Would that be your counterpoint to my counterpoint? A greedy and only cares, massive ego getting stroked. I mean, he really sucks at talking. I think it's a bad thing to be complimented, though. Why don't you trust rich people? You should always trust everybody. Nom nom the rich. Yeah, I know. Because Mark Zuckerberg is very good at copying. I think Facebook needs to die. Whether Elon has a case that would be that would work in terms of like Twitter and Threads, I don't know, but Facebook dude is very good at copying. That's the truth. Guys, you want rich friends. 'Cause then they can pay you for your dinner. I want to see the cage match. Oh, that would be fun. I think Elon is good at making things profitable. Because if he had not stepped in for Twitter, then yes, the What is a Woman video would have continued to be blocked as transphobic when it's not. And most likely Twitter at some point would have closed since they were losing quite a lot of money every year. Throw Bezos inside too. Mark is good at copying, but making stuff work. Okay, yeah, I read that one. And no tuition. 50% of them are snobs and throw stuff at your face. But you can use them. You can use some of them for your own gain. They have connections. Remember, your net worth is your network. Fair. Fair. I don't think all rich people are bad. Like, to say that all rich people are bad is no better than Fidel Castro, and he has his own problems. What do you mean Twitter's not a public forum? It's where teenagers go to, you know, to relieve themselves of their emotional frustration. Unless you look at the way Japan uses Twitter. There's not much writing. Poor but supportive. Okay. Oh, sweet! Go change out of your gym jams. They can censor anyone for any reason. True. That's pretty much with like any social media. I didn't know that this whole thing of like using certain words on YouTube, like including swearing, was like a no-no. I don't know, I guess I just missed that part where Americans went nuts. Lost their minds. And put another PJ on. Yeah, I agree, Block. That's my mic. Come on. There we go. Okay. Fixed. As people demand freedom of speech as compensation. for the freedom of thought they seldom use. I think that really depends on the person, but that does work really well with like crowds. Like, that's one thing I learned as a teacher. I thought people were smart, and I learned that we people are not. And if we put ourselves in a crowd of people that are not so smart, it usually doesn't end very well. Did you know there was this one philosopher scientist guy like around World War II time? He was the one that defined stupidity as a mental illness. Like, his solution to things were like, oh, people are just suffering from stupidity. The word gypsy, which is to identify a person who's not in the same place, I think. I thought gypsy were like the people like throughout history that just traveled through different countries. Like, they just kind of, you know, kind of like a caravan, like motorhomes, and they just roam around making money from music and stuff. I thought that was a gypsy. I guess maybe like the modern take on that is more of like someone who doesn't really settle. How is that insulting? It's the truth. Like, by that definition alone, I may as well be a gypsy. What did I do? Okay, there we go. People who suffer from stupidity are the smart ones who have to endure the stupid ones. The Romani people? But there's so many different types of gypsies. Like, Shakira is a gypsy. A lot of her family were gypsies. There's like an entire group of gypsies in Spain also. I don't see how that's insulting. Unless you're like using like a word in a derogatory way, but that, I think that would be kind of a different point, if that makes any sense. Hold on, I need to change my headset battery. Yelled at for using the word Eskimo. Oh, I heard about that briefly. So I used to live in like Illinois, which is kind of like middle-ish of America. I went to one of the the Natural Science Museum, something like that. It's like natural history, and there was a sign of, it said something like, someone posted a paper on this part of the museum saying that it was not correct to use the word Eskimos to describe the people that they were showing, because like they have this section where they show different clothing from different cultures. And then when I didn't see that part, that's just the part that my mom told me because she said it was on the news. So, you know, hearsay. What was on the museum was this like paper saying how if you donate to us, we can basically update the information we have. So instead of like using the word Eskimos, we can like search up what the individual groups are called and like better categorize our like stuff that we have. Gypsy on where I'm is very hated by Portuguese. Why? They have really good food. Inuit in Alaska prefer Eskimo. Comes from French word for snowshoes. Oh. And then English for word is just the English word for Inuit. And then Inuit. Wait. Eskimo is the word for Inuit, and then Inuit means snowshoes? Instead of Deutsch. I think the important part here is to talk with the people of said cultural group and ask them what their thoughts and opinions on it. Why be mad for someone else that may not be mad about it per se, you know? Who did that? Yuki! Koncha! Genki! How are you? Oh, snowshoes in French. Okay, sorry, never mind. If someone doesn't want to be called that, just don't use it. I'm going to ask Siri. No, that's my cash card. Oh, I need to unlock my phone. Define monolith. Nope. How do I say this word? Genki da yo! Kyo wa ironna omoshiroi hanashi o yatteru koko ni. Ah, all minorities. Have the same, yeah, nobody has the same opinions. Literally nobody. Whether you're majority or minority doesn't matter. I don't think we have to cater to... Okay, I think we have to... How do we say that? Don't own homes, and most of them demand stuff from city they're in, and since people are scared of them because them attack in groups. Since salted by internet will find you 100 that don't care. So, 今面白い話をやってる。例えばもし、カナダの中にエスキモという人たちが本当にその言葉が好きかどうか、担任がこういう言葉を使った方がいいか使わなかった方がいいかとか。I think we should cater to when we hurt someone's feelings, right? Not all the time, but I think we should be caring to each other. like too, I don't feel the important thing here is words per se, not all the time, but rather the image that you have of someone and how you, you know, and how we treat each other. Because while we do we are part of certain groups, right? Whether that's like our culture, our nation, our language, our sex, our type of job, our type of interests, like maybe you just really like art. We belong to different groups, that is true. But regardless of that, we don't all think the same, so we shouldn't forget the individual in the group. I don't know if that makes sense. But we also shouldn't forget the group, because I think like the purpose of living is that we learn how to live with each other, because we're here anyway, right? Like, I'm here, you're here, and we need to learn how to live with each other. Social anthropology student who wrote an essay theorizing it might be racist because it sounds like Latin for excommunicate. Well, that's silly. Thanks for the tooth, Matt. What's up? I'd rather not use the word than insult someone. Don't care if it limits. I don't think it limits your freedom of peach. Oh, oops. Looking at the chat. I've been in so much trouble just saying a race to specify some people, like people calling, but why? That has nothing to do with being racist. When it has nothing to do with that, we have lots of people from Greenland and Denmark and lots of people who are racist towards them. Greenlander? But that's what I was talking about. Like, it's more of your intentions. I don't think this is about, like, it can be partially about particular, I'm going to say vernacular, lexicon, words, but I think the more important thing is just how you treat each other and your intentions, and, you know, how sometimes we say things without actually literally saying it. Like, you may come off as mean if you are being mean, etc. Yeah, that's true. You'll just use something else if you want to. Specified people in China, but just the people who were involved, and they thought it was the whole Chinese community and didn't back down for that. Oh. the word was Chinese. Oh. I don't think the races care if the words are forbidden or not. Fair. I don't think that's racist either. Like, okay. Define racism, right? To really, truly hate someone simply because of who they are, as in where they are from. And I don't think we're living in the 1930s and 40s anymore. At least I hope not. But it, I don't think it's a bad thing. Block. One of the good ones. That actually happened though with what was that state called? Not Minnesota. What state was it? There's this one state in US. Arkansas, yeah, that's the state. Arkansas. How like a long time ago, one Indian nation talked to one white dude who couldn't pronounce the word for their group, like their name. And then that white dude talked to some other white dude. And then at that point, they're like, you know what? I don't really know how to say this, but we're gonna... Like, they tried to translate it, but they didn't do a very good job. And that's why the state is spelled like Arkansas, but it's actually pronounced Arkansas. But that doesn't mean someone is racist, because otherwise it wouldn't be called Arkansas, period. It would be something like, I don't know, New England or whatever. And like completely dismiss who was there. Like Arkansas. I also thought it was Arkansas until someone corrected me and said it. No, it's Arkansas. And I'm like, but it's spelled like Kansas, but with an R and a saw. Why? Being calling someone who is not that race. So you mean like calling me, I don't know, black when I don't look black? Is that, would that be racist? I'm asking this because I want to dig in your mind and understand you. They're Kansas. But that's not being racist. Being racist is like truly hating someone to the point where you don't want them to grow in any way. Whether it's to have a family and like reproduce, or to make money, or to live in your town, or, you know, have like a little sign like, what was it? No blacks, no Irish, no dogs, or something like that. Oh, okay. Enjoy your lookberry. I'm pretty sure that's a thing. What? I I was saying something, and then like you were saying something, and then I said something, and now I'm lost again. Now I am confusion. By other countries because they seem alike. Oh, that's just being ignorant. That's not being racist. That's just like you don't know. You don't know what you don't know. We don't all know everything. You know? But I wouldn't call that racist. It's more of like, are you trying or do you just not know? Because for most, here's a funny perspective on that. If you go to like Japan or South Korea, for them, a lot of Western people look the same. But that's mostly because there aren't that many living there anyway. So to my point being of like, you just don't really know. Not really. You're exposed to different things. But I wouldn't call it racist. Okay, I'll leave that alone. I know it's hard. You don't feel like talking. Yeah, that's right. That would be being racist. Yeah, I agree. I think that's more the case than anything. Shiz? From outside about the racist fact and stuff that I myself don't exactly. My mic! Test. Oh, I think it's my cable. It disconnects sometimes. But hey, like, we live all in different places, you know? We're never going to know the same stuff. We kill gay people because culture. Yeah, and there's already people from certain cultures who are from those cultures that are trying to fight against that in terms of making same-sex couples legal. I don't really know much about the... It's a culture, so... Like, I've only heard a little bit of it from, like, one podcast of the perspective of can't say anything because it's their culture, but there are actually those who disagree within that culture. And then they also have a network of like some feminists to try and make things better. So I think if you're going to say some, if someone is going to say, if someone says, let's, this imaginary person says, I can't say anything because maybe that's their culture, then probably my response to that would be like, well, then we, you need to learn more of their culture, right? To have a more informed opinion. That may not be a good idea, though, Doodle. There are a lot of countries where same-sex marriages are not legal. They're not. There are some places where they're not illegal, but they're not legal. Hot take. Ooh, hot take. On homosexuality. I think they're now pushing too much on sexuality on TV shows and stuff. Doesn't seem normal to me if it looks forced. Yeah, I agree with you, Block. There's actually, now that you say that, there's this one show on Netflix and it's about, was he Norwegian or Swedish? I was one of the, I always mix the Northern European countries. I need to learn a map. There's this show on Netflix about the prince and how it got out that he was gay because of this like one tape of him having sexy time with another classmate that, you know, they were dating. And it seems like okay as a teen drama. I'm not necessarily like the type of person to watch romance stuff anyway. I'm just more interested mostly because the character is a prince and most likely his life is vastly different from everybody else, you know, like with having guards and needing to learn different things and blah blah blah. But I think it was like from season 2 that I felt like the story isn't really going anywhere. Like it's a little more focused on the it feels like a not natural focus on the romance. Like, I don't care if they're gay or not. I really don't. It just, it, I get what you're saying. Like, for that show, I felt like, where is the story going? Because it seems to be, like, a little flat now. How much they should be represented in mass media. Then the plot point of the get focus on the relationship other than the plot point of the show. Yeah, I get what you mean. I mean, it's nice to see different people in stories, right? Whether it's TV, movies, music, whatever. As long as it doesn't feel like, as long as it feels natural, you know? Like it feels natural for ABC to be the bad guy. Like if you put, what's that? Okay, here would be a good example. If you played Whoopi Goldberg as like a villain, I don't think she would be believable as a villain. Who knows? Maybe she would be, but I don't think I could believe Whoopi Goldberg's character as a villain. It just, it wouldn't match, I think. Okay. So, what did you mean? Don't mind me, sometimes I tend to be off topic too. I tend to go on tangents quite a lot. Oh, there's a new Ghibli movie coming out, by the way. It's called How Do You Live? In countries in the Middle East, Africa, Eastern Europe, where being gay will get you killed. You mean like it's legally illegal to be gay? Yeah, that exists. Stop all foreign aid and close the embassies in those countries, because that's pretty much the same as being openly against Geneva Convention in my book. I get where you're getting with that, but to close because of this thing, you're closing it also for everybody else in those regions who aren't gay, who aren't LGBT. So like for every, you know, when it comes to political things like that, it's always a trade-off. Oh, that was a really big brush. I'm not saying I disagree with you. I'm just saying that, like, maybe there's another way where it doesn't hurt more people. I mean cultures. Two definitions. One to do with sports, art, music, food, so forth, other religion. Yeah, all that is culture. There's always troublesome people in whatever country that you're in. Probably, I would say a good thing to do is like learn more about the situation, right? Get to know the history of that place. Talk to a bunch of people, like hundreds and thousands, and you know, see what things they talk about, don't talk about, their opinions, their thoughts, their beliefs. To get like a better understanding of what's happening. Because what we do with religion and social beliefs also is in our pop culture too. They're not mutually distinguishable from each other. At least, I feel that way. Like, your pop culture can become a religion. Your political belief can essentially become a type of religion. I think it would be better if you work like with like the dignitaries and also people from local levels to see what is their points of view on what was it like it being illegal to have, because like would it be in that country, let's say in country A, would it be illegal to be gay, or would it be illegal or not legal to have same-sex marriages? And then, like, you know, the other legality that comes with marriage and whatnot. Like, I think that would be a way to go into it. Yeah, but I don't like hugging other people, so I don't want them to hug me. So I think in that sense, our beliefs are a little bit different, Doodle. Like, I think more of don't do... don't bother other people. Don't be bothersome. Don't do something that you wouldn't like. There was a movie I watched today. It was about to force people to notice what he was seeing, and what he was seeing, it was angelic stuff. See it, which they did not. Huh, that sounds interesting. Sounds like the Matrix. It sounds like the Matrix. Want me to stick my nose in their love life? And who they... consensually buglies with? Yeah. Can I say something? If someone else wants to say their sexual orientation, like who they are physically and sexually attracted to, cool. I don't mind. It's not something that I care to tell other people, because from my perspective, it's like none of their business. Like, if I like you, romantically speaking, and I'm interested in having a relationship, like a romantic relationship with someone, then, you know, they will know. But in terms of like, if someone Like, let's say some random person comes up to me and says, "Hey, Jesse, are you straight, bi, lesbian, whatever other word insert here?" My answer is, it's none of your business. I'm not in a relationship with you, and it shouldn't matter to you who I like and who I don't like. A lot of these things really don't matter in terms of getting to know the person. What matters is more of like, you know, can you talk with each other? Do you have like anything that you can have some connection with? And it doesn't have to be like the same same experience. Like, if you have empathy and can connect with someone else's feelings, I think that's also good enough. And eventually, when you hang out with each other more, then yeah, you'll figure out like who they're sexually attracted to, you know, who they are not attracted to, where they're from, and like stuff from their childhood. I just don't think it's something that is needed to be asked in that way. Like, I understand if someone's curious, you know? Like, maybe someone looks kind of different and you're like, what's their cultural background? Like, I get that. But I think there are more subtle ways to get to know that if you're really interested in, you know, being friends with that person and whatnot, whether they're your coworker, family, or whatever. And yeah, it totally agree, Doodle. And like the same thing, I believe the same for when it comes to if you have like a disease or a quote unquote mental disorder. You know, that's not the only part of your personality. The cool thing about our personalities and what makes us who we are is that you don't even know everything that makes who you are. But yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Long story short is that I don't think it's anyone's business to know who I like and who I don't like. Like, if they were to ask like this, and if they're not my friend. But if they are my friend, and you know, maybe we want to go to the pub and they wanted help to attract someone and get a date or something, then I'll help out. But like, yeah, I just don't think it's that big a deal. Here I am, like, slowly digging a hole for myself. I've heard of it. Forgot what it meant, though. Who also have attractive personalities. I mean, isn't that just kind of everybody? Like, as long as you're not a jerk. Yeah, I've heard of asexual also. And before anyone judges, no, I don't have anything against like anybody else's sexuality. I'm just wanted to say how I feel. Oh yeah, like pretty on the outside but ugly on the inside. That happens. If they think someone is attractive, if they don't get to know them. But isn't that like counterintuitive? Because like technically you don't know anybody, right? Can relate more to the opposite. I can find someone attractive physically, but then I see them sprint for the elevator. So there isn't space for baby carriage. I get what you mean. Do you have a baby carry kick, baby carriage doodle? Ah. Even if that person doesn't notice the baby carriage, now you got the mindset of he's a shithead. Ah, just you. Okay. True, but like there's always that's not even the full picture, right? Because that's just judging based on that isolated event. And who knows what their day was like. Maybe they're in a rush, who knows? I don't know the entire situation. But there's more to that. There's always more to that. Like, for example, there was this one time where I saw I don't know if they were traveling or if they just didn't know Japanese and were living there, but point is, they were not Japanese. And they were trying to order ice cream from 31, and they were kind of struggling, and I didn't help. But mostly because in that moment, I wanted to, like, see if they could do it or not. And then they were able to do it, so then I didn't help. If they don't get out when they see the single mom coming, there's no excuse. I get that. And yeah, luck, that's true also. I think what you mean, what Doodle's meaning to say is like, respecting and making space for someone else who may need it more than you, right? Like, if you see an elderly person in the train, and you have clearly sat in the section for like, old, pregnant, what's the other one? Like, if you have an injury, etc., or if you're like a child, then you know, like to give your seat to them. I think that's what this is about.
just a couple faces. Talking for hours changed my point of view, and that's the point of view. So tell me, what should I do now?
To make the excuse what makes other people do the same, then it's just cramped with 12 assholes in the elevator. Wait, you mean excuse as in, like, the excuse is that they're a single mom? Or, like, you know, elderly, pregnant, whatever? Oh, as in, please enter? Like giving a spot out because there's space for the mom. I think it really depends on the context. I used to live very black and white for a lot of things, and I've changed my perspective to the there's a bunch of gray areas and depends on context and people and blah blah blah. So like, if you are clearly trying to get that lift, right, you're like rushing, you're like, no, I need to get the lift now because I'm in a rush and I didn't, you know, I'm slow or whatever, I need to be there on time, and you are in the elevator and you see the person, like, you clearly, without a doubt, see the person dashing for that lift. I think it would be the nice thing to press a button to keep it open. But we shouldn't expect that from everybody all the time.
Like top. Oh, okay.
I usually just climb the stairs because exercise. Unless I was tired. Like, maybe I was shopping or something. And I have like two bags or one bag with me and I'm just tired. Then maybe I hang out on the escalator. Yeah, same. Oh, really? I think the only times I've used the elevators is when I had a suitcase or when I just couldn't find the stairs. Because I get lost. Floating escalators? What are those? Are those the ones you can see through? Escalator is just attached at the
beginning of the stairs and end. And then there's like what? At the beginning of the stairs. Oh, like those chairs that the like an older person sits on? Wait, I have to search this now. Floating lift. Oh, that's... I got floating boat lift. Floating escalator. Wait. Floating escalator. Wait, I don't get it. Am I looking at what I'm supposed to be looking at? It just looks like escalators. Oh, there are some, by the way, there are some crazy stairs and escalators in like, what's that train line? Man, I forgot train lines. Searching. I need a map of train lines. Wait, let me just Google. Oh, maybe Yudakucho-san? Yokosuka line, that's what it was. There's like these crazy three-story or two and a half, but it feels like three-story escalator and stairs that you can sometimes see in like Yokosuka line, Yokosuka-sen. Oh no! It's okay, I got your link. Okay, this is what Block sent. Because you can post a link if you're like a VIP, a subscriber. Like subscriber and up, you can post links. But I can see the messages. Also, if you have 7TV, you can see anything at any time. But yeah, I get what you mean. Okay, if you go to, for example, Shibuya Station, or actually they have it in Shinjuku also, and I think it's in Yokohama, somewhere in, I think somewhere by Yokohama Station, there's these stairs like those that go from the ground floor all the way to the fourth floor, and they're a little bit scary. Like, if you just happen to trip even a little bit, I would be scared for that person. Yeah. Oh, the black one's more scary. I get that. This one's okay. This one's okay. But if it goes from like 2 to 3 floors, then I get a little scared. But like when you're going down, you still feel it. Make her look down. If you if we're ever like in Japan at the same time, I will take you to Yokohama station and then you'll know what I mean, because when you exit Yokohama station, you might end up on like one of the upper floors and you have no choice but to look down. Yeah, right? Oh, cool. Same doodle, same. Does anybody else think that? Like, do you ever just have random thoughts of like, yeah, I could totally jump. I'm Spider-Man. I can survive this. Yeah. Wow, we did such a topic shift. But yeah, now I get what you mean by floating escalator. I don't like them very much. Like the ones you showed me, those are okay, because it's going from one level to the next level. It's just it's one level in between. But if it's like more than that, then they start like oof. You feel the oof. I think there was one like that in Amsterdam actually. It was from the metro, like maybe -2, floor -2, I don't know what it's called here, to like the main ground floor. It was pretty cool, but also a little daunting. So many intrusive thoughts. Oh, oops. Wait. Where was I? Oh. Okay, how about this? Whenever you finish watching a movie in the cinema and the character happens to be like super cool with superpowers, do you ever feel like after you've watched a movie and you're exiting that room, do you ever feel like, yeah, I have those superpowers too, I'm also a superhero in disguise, I'm gonna act all cool and natural so nobody notices? It becomes normal. Face your fears. I pretend to be a Jedi. Vroom. Okay. I don't know why, I just always like felt like that after watching some superhero movie. Or just where the character was really, really cool. And then exiting and thinking, yeah, I'm so cool. Nobody knows my secret. I know you can hear me. To be hidden things like glass, where he switches personalities and has powers in some of them. Oh, just if you got any potential mind. Oh man, I wish I had mind reading powers. What about any of other personality have superpowers? Oh, Glass movie, I mean. Glass movie? Is that the name of the movie? Well, clearly from the first thing I said, I have not seen it. Ooh, Samuel Jackson's in it. Ooh, Bruce Willis. Bruce Willis is really cool. I liked him in Fifth Element, 2019. Okay. I'll have to see it. Split it just about personality, dude. Oh. Is depression a superpower? I'll relate to that one. I don't remember the plot of the movie. Oh. Unbreakable. Calm not feeling anything is superpower. Willis, I'm looking now. Security guard survives fatal train accident only to be tracked down by a man named Elijah Price, who claims that David is blessed with superhuman abilities. Oh. I'll watch this too. Ooh, and James McCoy and Sam Jackson again. He's a good actor. Ooh. Why didn't you like it? The glass one? Anticlimactic. Oh. Okay. Young Royals, that's what the TV show is called. Let me check real quick. Prince Wilhelm. Wilhelm? The show I mentioned earlier, by the way. It's called Young Royals. Swedish. Okay. Sorry, it was bugging me. I had to look it up. You know, the one thing that I wish that show, going back to the whole things like gay stuff feels a bit forced and making things feel natural, I wish they had explored more of like people's perception and like, you know how with the royal family, there's like the help around them, whether they're in politics or just like helping them in the house or something? Like, it would have been interesting to see if they would have to change anything legally. Like, let's say if the prince did become the prince, you know? Like, I wonder if they would have changed anything. Oh, okay. Enjoy your lunch. And he's back from outer space. How has work so far? I still didn't find the ring fit. But hopefully it'll turn up at some point. And thank you to Barry. She introduced me to some workout by Chloe Ting. She has a ting, you know? So I was thinking of starting that today. So I don't feel totally bad about not finding the ring fit. Found me sitting here with that stupid look upon my face. I should have. How did it go? I should have never let you go if I know you'd be back to bother me. I am not amused. From work? Chicha, super luck. I would have made you leave your keys. Yeah, if I know you'd be back to bother me. Go on now. Go. Walk out that door. Just turn around now. Cause you're not welcome anymore. But I get that. Hopefully it's something that you can be a part of in the sense of making better change, like be part of the change, so that way you're still a valuable team member. Not always easy, though.
Excuse me.
I'm thinking of ending soon, though. I'm still wondering where I put the ring fit, where it was put last. It is what it is, too. It is what you make of it. True. True. Oh, Doodle, you would love this this phrase in Japanese. Shou ga nai. Shou ga nai. I don't know if you know it. Fair. Like this one time in my previous job where one of the concierge was able to convince. I keep forgetting the word convince. Was able to convince our boss for the concierges to use my booth. Okay, I call it my booth mostly because I'm the one that uses it most of the time, or used it most of the time. But convince our boss to not use it because the internet connection is not great. And then it's like right by construction, and this is in Ginza. There's always going to be some little construction here and there. When really the problem is that their router was too small and had a very limited range. So if you close the door to that booth, your internet connection will probably be lost sometimes. So I never closed the door, and then probably somebody else who used that booth on like the Sunday and Monday that I wasn't there probably said something about it. But I think she was leaving, like working for that company, and maybe just wanted like another place for the concierges to have their lunch. They already had a place to have lunch, but yeah. that made was changed, and then I tried to push back and it was not easy. I lost my booth. All because they don't understand how routers work. Hi, Donnie! How are you? I'm drawing water. Oh, enjoy the lurk pizza. Did I shy? Thick moth. Oh yeah, I should save. Thanks. Toshi mo genki da yo. Kono atarashi bamen ga dou? Dou omu? Chotto simpuru na eleganto na bamen o tsukuritakatta no kana? Yatta! It's simple. Oh, it's still saving. Dane. Shouga nai. Yokatta, yokatta. Ah, my mic. There we go. There's another artist that I saw her screen and thought, watashi mo sou simple na bamen ga hoshii na. So. Was saying that they're trying to move away from the phrase it is what it is to saying it is what you make it. And then I said me might like the phrase shoganai. That says okay. So I wondered, how would you explain the phrase shouganai?
Ne.
Berry's friend. And enjoy. Have fun. Ta-da shy. Still have this side. Okay, I'll finish this side on my free time. I'm going to try and exercise. because I said I would stream for 2 hours today. I want to try and make it like at least 2 hours or 2 hours 30 minutes, so it's a little easier for me in terms of like what to do with my schedules and making time to study. I need more time to study and more time to renovate. Yeah, I just need to figure out my schedule a little bit more. Google says it is what it is. It's kind of like it is what it is. Doodle, I'll if I don't have it already on Discord, I'll try to send you a link that may explain it a little better. Like, it kind of is, it is what it is, but kind of not, if that makes sense. But anywho, お疲れ様 です。 I'll finish here today, and then I believe I can stream tomorrow, maybe no mic stream, and just try and finish this so I can show you the next thing that I plan. Though Doodle, you probably already know what I'm working on. But you have a great day too, or morning, or evening, or afternoon, or midday, or whatever time it is for you. If you ever miss my streams, I'll just put them here in like the main channel. I won't die. I'll probably be really sweaty though. Probably. I'm kind of out of shape. But yeah, thanks for hanging out. And also, I should say thank you to Pizza for the resub, 32 months. Wow. For Block for the follow. Thank you, Block. It's been nice hanging out with you here. And then also to, I think, Nitrous03, if I'm saying that right. Thank you so much. I'll see you tomorrow around the same time as today. Yosh, mata ne. Enjoy your time. See you. Ciao.